the behaviorist research program was made obsolete by a series of studies that could convincingly falsify core assumptions of this paradigm. Although some theories were revised and now still live on in neo-behaviorism, its successor, cognitivism, can today be viewed as the mainstream for learning research. Cognitivists have dared to open up the black box and study the inner workings of the mind. Cognitivism started during the decline of behaviorism in the late 60s of the last century and is running up till now. One of its main contributors, Jean Piaget, once said, "Teaching means creating situations where structures can be discovered." This epitomizes the view of cognitivists. They now look into structures of knowledge and structures of the mind. How do they interact, and how is new knowledge formed? A metaphor that encapsulates how cognitivists view learning is that learning is the storing and processing of information. Human minds are information processing systems similar to computers. The basic setup on first sight is comparable to the behaviorist model. We have a subject that interacts with its environment to form a behavior or mental activity. And analogously to the behaviorist model, feedback and instructions are key elements. Only this time, the rational subject is active in a process of knowledge acquisition. Here, scientists analyze the way how the system receives, processes, organizes, and retrieves information. One central tenet of cognitivism is its attempt to understand and model mental functions such as perception, attention, memory, and higher thinking. By this, it could identify specifics of the human mind and crucial bottlenecks of the system, such as the cognitive load on the working memory. Cognitivists also look into how the mind structures and organizes its knowledge via schemas, scripts, and other representation formats, be they auditory, visually, or episodically. A crucial role here is the prior knowledge, as it constitutes the anchor for connecting new information, a process called elaboration. Another area of interest are environmental factors and instructional components. How must they be set up to ensure a robust memory trace? At the core of it all is the question what the subject actively does with the new knowledge. How does the learner realize its learning? Here, cognitivists state that the more active and in-depth the learning activities are, the more sustainable the learning is. As mentioned earlier, cognitivism can be viewed as the mainstream of learning as of today. Nevertheless, let's have a quick look at the core assumptions of this learning paradigm. Humans come evolutionarily prepared and are natural learners. This also holds true and is a direct implication of the theory of evolution. Humans learn by reasoning and insight? Well, this can be validated via a plethora of studies in the cognitive sciences. Also, the notion of learning as an active process by the learner is a very vital and important core finding that greatly informs modern didactics. Cognitivists also very often break down the human mind and its workings into systems, components, processes, and interactions. This is a very fruitful enterprise, however, it bears the risk of reducing and discretizing the learning process too much, a shortcoming constructivists later on aimed to alleviate. And lastly, the metaphor of human minds as information processing systems it only holds true to a specific degree. Human memory, for example, does not operate like a hard disk drive. Memory traces dynamically self-organize and change over time and are thus prone to error and bias. How does cognitivism inform your teaching? Well, in a myriad of ways, and here are only three examples. For once, it can help you in your design of your learning scenarios, in a way that you take into account the specifics of the human attention and memory system, so that you will not overload the working memory of your learners. Also, the emphasis and focus on active and deep learning, on getting your learners to most effectively work with the learning materials, and also connect those with their prior knowledge. It could be shown that a high prior knowledge is actually the best predictor for eventual learning success. Thirdly, you as an expert can convey your strategies, your problem-solving abilities, and your metacognitive skills to your learners so that they can better structure their learning. Cognitivist theories constitute the foundation of both our courses and consultation practices here at ProLehre Medien und Didaktik. I hope you found this brief summary both engaging and interesting. If you want to know how to foster a more active and effective learning in your students, just get in touch with us. Take care. Bye-bye.